We're going to see in this video first how the computer sees the images, then the difference between color and grayscale and some basic operation on this image. So first we import CV2, import NumPy as np image. CV2 in red. Now we load the image. I create image called flag.png. You can download it from the link in the description. Flag.png. CV2 in show. Flag image. CV2.weight key 0. CV2 dot destroy all windows. Let's show. Okay, this is the image. This is how we see it. But if we print it, image, this is how the computer sees the image. So each pixel, it's made of three channels, so each one of these is a pixel. So this one is a blue pixel because it has 255 of blue, 0 green and 0 red. And here it's just a small sample. Where are the dots? There are of course this pixel, just the terminal cannot print all of them. So let's for example create an image of ourselves, designing pixel by pixel so that it will be more easy to understand. Image equals np.array. So basically we are just going to create a list, an array. We're going to use NumPy because NumPy is faster than normal array. So CV2 works only with NumPy. And of course you need to have something really fast. For example, when you do some processing on the videos, when you have to work on like 60 frames each second, so the operations on the image must be really quick. Take the least CPU as possible. So np.array, so we create the array, so open brackets, then open again brackets, and this is the first row. As we have the first row, we open again the brackets, and this is our first pixel. And we want it to be blue, 255, 0, 0, comma. I'm going to copy, let's draw a few pixels. So one, we have it already, 2, 3, 4, 5 pixels. And remember to define the type of the array, in this case, np.uint. 8. Let's show this image. So we can see here just really small line, just 5 pixels, only this part. Now let's create more rows. So this pixel, each one of this is the column, and this is the row. So let's copy this one. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We print it and we see that here we have a really small blue square that we are drawing pixel by pixel. And for example, let's change all the blue pixels with red. So let's change this code, find, replace. We'll take all the blues and we will change with the green. So 0 to 55, 0. Replace all. Show, and you can see we have a really small green square, and this is how the computer draws the pictures pixel by pixel. Even big full HD images, if you will print them, you will see something like this. So let's see how to change from the image pixel by pixel. So for example, image, we load again cv2.im, read flag dot png, so for example, let's take some random pixel somewhere here in the center. So the center will be, let's first see the size of the image, print image dot shape. Size is the 350 rows and 600 columns, so it will be around 175 from here, so row, and from the column position 300. So print image, so we open brackets and we take just one pixel. So as I said, 175 and 300, and we are taking a green pixel, so this is the result. We are printing this pixel in the center, and the result is 0 to 55, 0. What if we want to change that pixel? Again, we will say image bracket 175 comma 300 equals, and now we'll draw a blue pixel, so 255, 0 and 0. Here, if you have HD resolution on the screen, you can see that there is a small dot, so one pixel exactly blue. And let's draw a few more of them so it will be easier to see them. So a small line now. Here we can see there is small blue scratch, and we are changing them pixel by pixel. What if the image was grayscale? In this case, let's say image gray scale equals cv2.cvtColor, then image cv2.color bgr to gray. We show the image grayscale only. In this case, each pixel has just one channel. So if we print image grayscale, we will see that I'm not sure if this is really clear. This is one pixel, this is the second pixel, third pixel, and so on. And from zero, it will go from zero, that is completely white, to 255, which is completely black. And here we have different gradients, of course. And here in this case, you can change the value of a pixel, so it will be image grayscale. Let's, for example, draw a white pixel somewhere. Let's say here a white pixel. Image grayscale brackets. Let's get first the position. So it will be 175 around 100. And white, probably I did a mistake before, 0 is completely black and 255 completely white. And here we have our white pixel. So one more thing now, just how to take some part of the image, call ROI, region of interest. Now let's work with a different image, red panda, that I used in some previous video, and you can download also this one from the link in the description. Redpanda.jpg. Panda image, let's see. Okay, from this panda, for example, I want just to get the snout, so only this part. How to do that? We need to define which rows we want to get and which columns. So if we print the image, the shape print shape image dot shape, we have 300 rows and 500 columns and 3 channels, so it will be columns, rows, channels equals image.shape. So we can say ROI equals image bracket. So we take first from the column 0 to col. So then it's 300, so it's the total column, I'm doing sick, the rows, so now I'm with the rows. And from column 0 to all the columns, so column, let's say, column. Let's print, let's show, not print, cv2.imshow ROI. Okay, I made a mistake. So we have rows first, columns. Okay, makes sense now. And here we have same images, of course, because I'm taking all of it. Then from let's cut the image. So instead of taking all the rows, I want to take somewhere here. Let's say from pixel more or less 150, 150. And you can see exactly the half. But I took too much, so from 100. And it's okay, then not all of it, so not 300, but 280. And then from the column number 200. So a bit less, 150, 2, let's say around 320. And here we have our region of interest. And we will continue in next videos to do some operations on the images. And for this video, it's all.